Strategy is fundamental to the success of any team. Delivering a strategic plan is one of the most important things any team, regardless of size, can undertake. A well-formulated and executed strategy can lead to victory at the build table and at the competition field. And yet many people find strategy and its purpose difficult to articulate.
Welcome to the VEX Guide on Effective Game Analysis. In this video, we will learn how to effectively analyze a competition game, successfully develop viable game strategies, and hone analytical skills. Step 1. Watch the game overview animation for this season's game. You could find this just by searching for it using the search engine of your choice, or it is also on the VEX website. Step 2. Read the game manual and its appendices. You can also find this by navigating through the VEX website. Make sure to read the manual completely, making sure to pay the most attention to the rules concerning robot size and part restrictions. Step 3. Read the manual again. This time, make light annotations on the important aspects of the game, such as ways on how to score, as well as build restrictions. Step 4. Yes, you guessed it, read the manual yet again. By doing so, we can help reduce clutter on the VEX forum for questions that can easily be answered by carefully reading the game manual. Highlight and understand all the ways to score points. Make sure to mark down the most common way to score points, as well as the most rewarding way. Remember to do this for the robot and programming skills manuals as well. It is also beneficial to know different ways to stop your opponent from descoring, or any ways to descore your opponent's already scored game elements.
Step 5. Break down the game into simple tasks that lead to winning matches. Determine the most optimal, efficient, and reliable way to win matches, based on the information gathered in steps 3 and 4. Note, make a list of all potential ways to deny points, no matter how obscure they may be. In any competition, regardless of type, the ability to de-score your opponent's points is priceless. Many teams only focus on scoring points, not realizing the value towards winning a match that is provided by denying points. Step 6. Make a list of all the building and design limitations, such as the size constraints of the robot, motor and pneumatic limits, as well as special rules that nullify or modify these limits. These details can be found in the official game manual. Step 7. Determine what tasks the robot should be able to do. Don't try to solve technical problems with the design. Define clear objectives you want the robot to accomplish. Make a table of these tasks in one column and derive quantitative abilities of the robot. Now you should be able to brainstorm and craft a plan for version 1 of the robot.
Step 8. Scheduling. Before any building gets done, make a calendar for all the meeting times. Reserve the week of the competition for driver practice and an additional week before driver practice for autonomous and programming skills.